That I can't answer. All I know is that I just got in town, and my friends told me about a place where I could stay for cheap and all. And, well, I liked it. The neighborhood was nice. The building was nice. The landlady was nice. And the room was nice. All I needed was a little fixing up. So, I fixed it up. Boy, a real studio-like place where I could write and all. You see, I'm a writer. My name's Algernon. But my friends call me
Harry.
Evidently, it must have started when I bought the picture. I really didn't like it. But the guy in the place was so old. And I'm so sensitive. So I bought it. I mean, the picture was really nothing with that guy on that little boat. Really nothing to look at, you know. Even my friends say it.
You know, Harry, not for anything, but that picture's really nothing to look at.
And yet, after a few days, just hanging around the house, you know, I found myself like always being drawn to it. Of course, I thought nothing of it. But like my eyes, always met it. Sure, I tried to keep it out of my mind. Like sometimes, I even tried to write. I'm a writer, I told you, yes. But I found I could only write when I felt it. When I was inspired enough, you know. So then, the worst part was breaking out of looking at it when I had to work to get inspired. I just can't explain it. I was being drawn to it. I even found it hard to eat. But I figured that all of this was because of my intense sensitivity. And because I have a vivid imagination. Even my friends say it.
You know, Harry, you got a vivid imagination.
It got so that even the Late Late Show number 3 didn't help.
Have you heard about Swivel Hip Sal? A grand old gal. Oh, let me tell you about Swivel Hip Sal. Never needed a pal with a hey, nanny, nanny, and a ho, ho, ho. She brought the heat to Mexico, and for the boys a bit late, titty caca, she would shake her naughty maraca.
One more time!
And for the boys a bit late, titty caca, she would shake her naughty maraca.
Well, there it is, Skipper. Just like I showed you on my funny little map. Skipper, have you ever heard of Kong?
Why, yes. Some native superstition, I believe.
Superstition? I doubt it. We know this much. It's something big, something monstrous, holding that island in a grip of deadly fear.
So there I was. I couldn't write, I couldn't eat, and now I couldn't sleep. Even my friends began to notice in me that there seemed to be something amiss.
You know, Harry, there seems to be something amiss.
I was ashamed to tell anybody. I mean, like, what would people say?
Throw a party.
So I did. For the first day and a half of the party, it was like that. There she was. Nothing happened. Nothing at all. I could eat. I could write. now I could sleep. She was a real good catch. Even my friend said it.
You know, Harry, I don't want to be nosy or anything, but man, she was a real good catch.
So I married her. Nothing was too good for us. We even had our honeymoon at the New York World's Fair. Unfortunately, it was still under construction. We didn't mind. We didn't mind at all. Oh, I was madly in love. But, of course, like they say,
all good things come to an end.
And so the honeymoon was over. And there we were, back home. Married and all. Living a normal married life and all. Me, I settled down to write my confessions. I'm a writer, you know. And her painting her paintings, because that's what she was. A painter of paintings. An artist, you know. Yes, sir, nice and easy. Nothing to worry about. No picture, nothing. Just easy living. She loved to paint nature. You know, flowers and all. Trees. Birds. Water. Water. More water. Lots of water. And then it happened. But this time, I didn't panic. I remember what my analyst told me.
Harry.
She said,
Harry, if you really want help, you must help yourself. You gotta fight it. You gotta hit it hard, in the guts. Blood and thunder and all like. It's all in the mind, boy. The only way to do it is to stare it down. Straight, cold. Stare it down, boy. Stare it down.
Sure, it was so obvious. Why, even my friend said it.
Harry, if you really want help, you must help yourself. You gotta fight it. You gotta hit it hard in the guts, blood and thunder and all like. It's all in the mind, boy. The only way to do it. Harry? Hey, Harry. Harry, you okay? Hey, Harry, where are you, Harry? Harry? Hey, Harry. Come on now, don't fool around. Where are you, Harry?
Hey, listen! I forgot my analyst. She told me something else, too. She said that life is fraught with peril.
Geez, you know, Harry, life is fraught with peril.